This video is going to be an introduction to mathematical sequences. So let's get a general idea of what a sequence is. Basically, in math, a sequence is a list of items, very often numbers, and the list has a specific order. So in other words, if I write the list 1, 2, 3, 4, you can see that there's an order to these numbers. They keep increasing by 1. If I'd written 4, 3, 2, 1, that would be a different sequence. Now, each of the numbers I've written is called an element or a term in the sequence. And I might have a sequence that just keeps going, that has an infinite number of elements or terms. And if I want to show that, since I can't write all those numbers, after the last one that I write, I'll just put 3 dots, which are called an ellipsis. And that shows that this sequence just keeps going on to infinity. If I want to show that it goes up to some high number, like let's say 100, then after the ellipsis, I'll write the last number of the sequence. So now I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, then the ellipsis, and then the 100. So that shows that basically my sequence starts at 1 and ends at 100. Now there are different categories or types of sequences. Let's talk about some of the more popular ones. So here I've got 3 sequences. The first one is 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, and then an ellipsis. So it's going to keep going. As you can probably tell, what I've done here is I've just added 2 to each term to get the next term. So when I add 2 to 6, I get an 8. When I add 2 to 8, I get a 10. 2 added to 10 is 12, and so on. When I've got a sequence, and what I'm doing is adding a constant term, a constant amount, to each term to get the next one, this is called an arithmetic sequence. And the number I add is called the difference. Very often they'll designate it with a D, and they'll say something like, for this one, D equals 2. D stands for difference, because if I take the difference between 8 and 6, 8 minus 6 is 2. If I take the difference between 10 and 8, 10 minus 8 is 2. The difference between 12 and 10 is 2, and so on. So 2 is the common difference for this 6, 8, 10, 12, 14 sequence. In the same way, the next sequence I've written, 0, 5, 10, 15, 20, going up to 80, is again an arithmetic sequence. And in this case, D, the difference, is 5, because I've added 5 to each term. I can also subtract a number, or if you want, add a negative number. So if I have the sequence 100, 90, 80, 70, and then going down to 10, what I'm doing is I'm subtracting 10 from each number, or if you want, we can say that I'm adding a negative 10. So the difference in this case is going to be negative 10. Okay, so that's basically the idea of an arithmetic sequence. You're adding a constant amount to each term to get the next one. We also have another kind of sequence. Let's take a look at these three sequences. Here I've got 2, 4, 8, 16, 32. Now, the difference changes. From 2 to 4, my difference is 2. From 4 to 8, my difference is 4. From 8 to 16, my difference is 8. And what I'm doing basically here is I'm multiplying each term by 2 to get the next term. 2 times 2 is 4, 4 times 2 is 8, 8 times 2 times 8 is 16, and so on. When you have a sequence in which the terms result from multiplying by some common number, this is called a geometric sequence. A geometric sequence. And the number you're multiplying everything by is called the common ratio, and very often that'll be shown with an R. In this one, we'll say R equals 2, because the ratio of 4 to 2, or 4 over 2, is 2, and the ratio of 8 over 4, in other words, the fractions that I'm making, is also 2. 16 over 8 is 2, and so on. So the common ratio for this first sequence is 2. The next sequence I've got here is 3, 30, 300, 3000, and so on. That's what the ellipsis is showing. And I'm multiplying by 10 in each case. So the common ratio is going to be 10. Now, a geometric sequence doesn't have to increase, it could decrease. So my last sequence here, 64, 32, 16, 8, 4, 2, and 1, is decreasing. The common ratio, let's find out what that is. If I take 32 and divide it by 64, that's the second term divided by the first term, well, that equals 1/2. And then if I take the third term, 16, and divide it by the second term, that's going to give me 1/2. And this will keep going all the way through this. So my ratio here, my common ratio, is 1/2. Okay, so that's a geometric sequence. A few more that I just want to mention. Here I've got the sequence 1, 4, 9, 16, 25, 36. Now, you may recognize these as perfect squares. 1 squared is 1, 2 squared is 4, 3 squared is 9, 4 squared is 16, and so on. So this is a sequence of perfect squares. In the same way, my next sequence, 1, 8, 27, 64, 125, is a sequence of cubes, or third powers. 1 to the third power is 1, 2 to the third power is 8, 3 to the third power is 27, 4 to the third power is 64. And the last kind of sequence I want to mention is, well, here's an example of it. Let's see if we can figure out what's happening. I start with a 0 and go to 1. And then I go to another 1. And then 2. And then 3. And then 5. And the question is, where would I go next? Well, this is called a Fibonacci sequence. Let me write that. Fibonacci. And the way this works is this. I take the first two terms, 0 and 1, and I add them together. So 0 and 1 equals 1. Then I take the second term and the third term, 1 and 1, and I add them together to get the fourth term, which is 2. Then I take the third term and the fourth term, I add those together and I get a 3. So in other words, to find the next term, I'm always taking the two previous terms and adding them together. So when I get to 3 and 5, and I want to find what the next one is, what the next term is, I add those together and I get an 8. Then I can add the 5 and the 8 and get a 13, add the 8 and the 13 and get a 21, and so on. If you do some research about Fibonacci sequences, you might find out that they occur in nature, patterns in nature, all over the place, and they're kind of interesting to study. But that's a little bit beyond this video. Okay, so at any rate, that's basically the introduction to sequences. I hope this helped. Take care. I'll see you next time.